I remember we set ourselves up with a challenge. I think we called it Pursuit of the 1% Drivetrain. And this was about 2 years ago. What that means is we wanted to eventually create a 99% efficient drivetrain, but we didn't know what the next step was or really what the future held for us. In hindsight, it's beautiful what happened to get to that goal, but back 2 years ago, we really didn't know what we were getting into. We always figured that the driven drivetrain would be very aero. Heck, we're removing the rear derailleur, removing the chain, and if it's compared to a 2x, we're removing the front derailleur and an extra ring. But this was only speculation, and we didn't have a way to prove that theory until we took it to the wind tunnel. You know, there was a small doubt in my mind, only because we didn't know how dirty that air was by the time it got back to the rear hub and the rear axle assembly. But what we found out in the wind tunnel testing is that area where the rear derailleur resides does make a big difference. And removal of the rear derailleur and the chain itself and the wide cassette definitely increased the aero efficiency. When you look at driven essentially contains a flat rear cog and a shaft that runs along the axis of the bike, so its frontal area is very minimal. After wind tunnel testing, we found that we had created the world's most aerodynamically efficient road bike.
How did that feel?
It felt amazing. It felt like we scored a touchdown. It felt like we won the Super Bowl. I'm trying to watch the F-bombs, man. Yeah, I'm trying to be a little professional here. Yeah. Here we go, in case you need one. It was fucking awesome.